Cool and dark fell the autumn night, but the Bashaba's wigwam glowed with light, for down from its roof by green withes hung, flaring and smoking, the pine knots swung. And all along the river great wood fires shot into the night their long red spires, showing behind the tall dark wood, flashing before on the sweeping flood. Now in the changeful wind the shimmer and shade, now high, now low, that firelight played, on tree leaves wet with evening dews, on gliding water and still canoes. The trapper that night on Turi's brook, and the weary fisher on Contacook, saw over the marshes and through the pine and down on the river the dance lights shine. For the Saugus sachem had come to woo the Bashaba's daughter, Weetamoo, and laid at her father's feet that night his softest furs and wampum white. From the crystal hills to the far southeast, the river sagamores came to the feast, and the chiefs whose homes the sea winds shook sat down on the mats of Penacook. They came from Sunapee's shore of rock, from the snowy sources of Snooganook, and from rough coos whose thick woods shake their pine cones in Umbagog Lake. From Amanusic's mountain pass, wild as his home, came Chepawas, and the Kenumps of the bills which throw their shade in the smile of Manitou. With pipes of peace and bows unstrung, glowing with paint, came old and young, in wampum and furs and feathers arrayed, to the dance and feast the Bashaba made. Bird of the air and beast of the field, all which the woods and waters yield, on dishes of birch and hemlock piled, garnished and graced that banquet wild. Streaks of the brown bear, fat and large, from the rocky slopes of the Kearsarge, delicate trout from Babusuck Brook, and salmon speared in the Cantacook. Salmon. Squirrels which fed where nuts fell thick on the gravelly bed of the Otternick, and small wild hens in reed snares caught from the banks of the Sundagardi brought. Need to look these places up. Pike and perch from the sun cook taken, nuts from the trees of the Black Hills shaken, cranberries picked in the Swampscott bog, and grapes from the vines of Piscatog, and drawn from that great stone vase which stands in the river scoop by a spirit's hands, garnished with spoons of shell and horn, stood the birchen dishes of smoking corn. Thus bird of air and beast of the field, all which the woods and waters yield, furnished in that olden day the bridal feast of the Bashaba. And merrily when that feast was done, on firelit green the dance begun, with squaws, shrill stave, and deeper hum of old men beating the Indian drum. Painted and plumed with scalp locks flowing, and red arms tossing and black eyes glowing, now in the light and now in the shade, around the fires the dancers played. The step was quicker, the song more shrill, and the beat of the small drums louder still, whenever within the circle drew the Saugus sachem and Weetamoo. The moons of 40 winters had shed their snow upon that chieftain's head, and toil and care and battle's chance had seamed his hard, dark countenance. A fawn beside the bison grim, why turns the bride's fond eye on him, and whose cold look is not beside the triumph of a sullen pride? Ask why the graceful grape entwines the rough oak with her arms of vines, and why the gray rock's rugged sheep the soft lips of the mosses seek? Why, with wise instinct, nature seems to harmonize her wide extremes, linking the stronger with the weak, the haughty with the soft and meek.